Blackstone Audio presents And on the Eighth Day by Ellery Queen. This book is read by Mark Peckham. Chapter 1, Sunday, April 2nd. Somewhere sagebrush was burning, but on neither side of the road could Ellery see smoke. Once he thought he saw fire. It turned out to be an ocotillo shrub in flaming flower. Either the spring rains had fallen earlier than usual, or the elevation in this part of the desert brought occasional rainfall throughout the year. He decided it was a campfire, perhaps from a wish. He had run across no human trail for hours, except the road itself. A fuzzy whim had made him turn off into the state road east of Hamlin, named, a sun-roasted marker said, after Lincoln's first vice president. The road had been passable as far as it went. The trouble was, it had not gone far enough. About 50 miles from Hamlin, it suddenly became an untidy wound. The California Highway Department's crew had evidently been caught in mid-repair by the outbreak of the war. Rather than backtrack Hamlinwood, Ellery had chanced a detour. He had long since regretted the gamble. The rutted and rotted road failed to connect with the state highway. After hours of jouncing, Ellery was convinced that it was no detour at all, but a lost wagon trail of the pioneers leading nowhere. He began to feel uneasy about water. He saw no signs. He did not even know if he was still in California or had crossed into Nevada. The sweet burn odor died. He had forgotten it by the time he saw the wooden building up ahead. Ellery should have set out for Hollywood earlier, but the prospect of bucking the pre-Christmas traffic and spending the holiday alone in a motor court somewhere had decided him to wait. That and the remark of the chain-smoking government man with whom he had discussed his trip.
The way things stand, Mr. Queen, we can spare gas for your car a lot easier than space on a plane or train. Or, for that matter, a bus.
In that December of 1943, depots and terminals and waiting rooms across the land demanded, "Is this trip necessary?" And they were all packed with people who clearly thought the answer was yes. Businessmen waiving priorities, students pointing home for their last civilian vacations, recruits on noisy boot leave, beribboned brass in perfect custom-made uniforms, combat veterans wrapped in silence, and everywhere, sweethearts and pregnant brides and wives clutching children. "Going to see my daddy, he's a soldier." Or sailor. Or marine. Or airman. Or coast guardsman. Servicemen unable to wangle a Christmas furlough. And it was all strident with gaiety. "He'll be so happy. He's never seen the baby." And tears. "Then I'll stand. I don't need a seat. Please?" And the unspoken, unspeakable words, "But I've got to get there. I may never see him again." "I'll drive," Ellery had said. So he had spent Christmas Eve at home with his father and the radio. Christmas Day brought church, unrationed turkey, and a walk in Central Park, after which the inspector snugged down with his latest leisure project, a rereading of Gibbon's Decline and Fall, replete with clucks over the misdeeds of some royal Byzantine gangster, while Ellery wrote appallingly overdue letters. On the 26th, he had packed and rested for the journey ahead, which he contemplated with no joy whatsoever. He had been working hard, and his bones lacked bounce. At 8 the next morning, he piled his suitcases into the antique Duesenberg, embraced his father, and took off. By some leer of fate, several of the servicemen he picked up early in the trip spelled him at the wheel while he was still fresh. But after he crossed the Mississippi, when he was beginning to feel the strain, not one of the hitchhikers he stopped for proved able to drive or had a license. So, by the evening of December 31st, when he pulled into a Hollywood already boiling over with New Year's Eve good cheer, he was weary in every cell and desperate for a hot bath and a good mattress.
"I know, Mr. Queen." We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.